bit more familiar. I wasn't really paying attention because I was making a damn vid. Sometimes that's the way it comes out. But here we are at the two. I noticed the two in the key of G, which is A. There's a two right there. And it's easy when you start playing the two like this. This happened to be recliner shape. And you just concentrate on those three strings and you don't see the rest of the chord. You're like, oh man, that's part of this. The famous A minor chord down here. Play that one right there. That's a recliner shape. There it is. That's the famous Yngwie shape right there. But he doesn't do it that way. I do it this way. I took the Yngwie shape and made my own way out of it. I didn't have no maps or nothing. I just did whatever my ears could do, and it turned out that, you know, I was actually improving myself because I was forcing my hand to stretch. So that's why I could do these humongous stretches, thanks to Yngwie. And then Tony McAlpine added that onto it. Come find out on video, he's all doing it on taps right here, and I'm doing like this. I got my hand all stressed out doing that. So it's second nature, you know. So that's the way I do it. Anyway, he does it like this. And then he brings it around, he does it. And I can see how my spirit is automatically connected with him, because when I first started learning his arpeggio sound, I was just going by the sound. I couldn't figure out his three note stuff, so I just did the number five box when I was like a young teenager, like this. And I'd go up and down the next like that. Did my own little thing, you know. But it was a two note. Come to find out that's what Yngwie does. He's, you know, muscle memory that he waited to do it. Or however he does it, but that's the way he does it. I just happen to do it whatever I could hear and figure out, and that's what caused my hand, you know. I got a humongous stretch, man, and it's strong as shit. I ain't seen nobody on the YouTube can do what this hand can do. This is a unique hand.